mysteriology.
They're bound to find out the minute we get there.
Yeah, it'd be too late, buddy. It was just act of surprise as they are.
I won't need to act. Sid?
Yes?
Well, we have to take all our clothes off. Can't we keep something on?
Don't worry, I'll do that.
Yo, what's up, cinephiles? Peter Bradshaw here from The Guardian. My first film this week is basically the movie of the year, Clemency by Chinonye Chukwu.
How do you keep doing it?
I do my job.
These next 24 hours are crucial. Anthony's defense attorney has already asked for a reprieve from the governor's office.
You want to play as good guys and bad guys. And I'm one of the bad guys. But I give these men respect. All the way through.
Alfre Woodard basically deserves an extra large solid gold Oscar encrusted with diamonds for her performance as Bernadine, an American prison warden who has presided over 12 executions, but as the 13th dawns, like someone in some grim, superstitious parable, she finds her mind beginning to bend and crack. Perhaps as a result of being a Brit, I tend to think of dramas about capital punishment as having something to do with the olden days, something to do with Albert Pierpoint, or Ruth Ellis, or Anne Boleyn. But of course the medicide ritual of America's criminal justice system is very contemporary. It's about the here and now. Everyone in this incredibly good film is basically brilliant. Alfre Woodard herself, obviously, as the warden. Wendell Pierce as her husband. Aldis Hodge as the condemned man. Richard Schiff as his careworn defense lawyer. Clemency is on streaming platforms right now. Check it out. Now, if you're a fan of Hugh Jackman, and you're a fan of Allison Janney, and you're a fan of Alexander Payne's 1999 high school satire classic Election, then in my view, that puts you in the Venn diagram sweet spot of unimpeachable good taste. And it means you're probably going to like this film, Bad Education, written by Mike Makowski and directed by Corey Finley.
A district superintendent.
Long Island, the town is only as good as its
public schools.
The better the school system, the higher the price tag on the homes.
These are the best early decision numbers that we've ever seen.
I wanted to make a difference. I got us all the way to number four, and I will get us to number one.
Get us to first. That's all that matters.
Hey, Frank.
Yeah?
I've been doing some digging. I'm concerned with what I found.
In this movie, based on a true story from 2002, Hugh Jackman plays a district school supervisor in Long Island near New York, which is an administrative job higher than a head teacher, the equivalent in British terms of a chair of the governor's. He presides over a very, very successful and aspirational public, that is to say publicly funded, school. And his number two is played by Allison Janney. They are both very, very good at their jobs and very, very successful. And the school is very, very successful too, which means that nobody quite questions the fact that huge amounts of taxpayers' money are lavished on this school. And yet the infrastructure of the school doesn't seem to be that good. And yet both these school officials appear to be very wealthy. Hugh Jackman's school official meets his nemesis in the form of high school student Rachel, played by Geraldine Viswanathan, who's writing a story for the school paper about the school itself. And reeking with complacent condescension, he advises her to go for a proper investigative piece of reporting, which she does with terrifying results. Hugh Jackman plays a man with a secret, a man who's lived with his secret for so long and trained himself not to think about his secret for so long that it's turned him into an avoidant sociopath. My colleague Benjamin Lee, in his review of the film when it came out in Toronto, made the interesting point that Hugh Jackman is very inscrutable. And I think that's absolutely right. The inscrutability of his performance is what's so fascinating. He's intriguingly unreadable in the role. As with Alexander Payne's Election, the dramatic charge of this film resides in the unthinkable horror of being intimately humiliated in front of children. Bad Education is available now on the Sky Cinema streaming platform and Now TV. My last film this week is an impossibly delicate, fragile, hothouse flower of arthouse cinema. It's A Portuguese Woman by Rita Azevedo Gomez.
Oh,
Portuguese Woman is based on the 1924 short story by the Austrian author Robert Musil, who is more famous for his unfinished Meisterwerk, The Man Without Qualities. Now, be warned, this film is an uncompromising example of slow cinema. It's contemplative, it's ruminative, it's composed in a series of beautifully wrought, static tableau shots. It doesn't give up its meaning easily to the viewer. It's very elegant, it's very mysterious, it's very marvellous and gorgeous. Now, the thought of that might make you want to run for the hills, and if it does, fair play, no disrespect, that's your choice. But if you give this film a chance, it will grow on you and cast its spell. Clara Riedenstein plays the unnamed flame-haired Portuguese noblewoman who gets married to a haughty Italian lord, played by Marcello Urquerque, and when he goes off to war, she remains behind with all her retinue of courtiers and ladies-in-waiting and simply waits for him to come back, which after a decade, he duly does, exhausted, unwell, and disillusioned with war's supposed glories. And really, that's it. That's really the sum total of the film. And yet it's kind of shimmering with mystery and enigma and a subtle eroticism. Do check it out if you can. It's on Mubi. That's it for this week. Traditionally, I finish with a plea for you to share this on social media and to subscribe, and I duly repeat this plea right now. But also, if you're a follower of the media, you might know that the paper that I work for, The Guardian, is in a pretty tough financial spot right now. So what I'm going to do is direct your attention to the link that I've posted at the bottom of this vlog, which shows you how to subscribe to the paper and how to help it with a membership. Please do so. Thank you very much.